Those were Madiba's main slogans at the time. It's very unfortunate that Matiba has died. Matiba has died a premature death. Many people of his generation are still alive. His death has been caused by effects of torture and the denial of medical treatment during his detention under the Moist regime in the 1990s. He joins a long list of all those who are tortured, who died, and who were economically destroyed so that this country can be free. Like Jesus Christ, he has died for our sins. He died so that we can be free. We who are left alive should not let this sacrifice be in vain. Let us keep the fires of freedom burning in this country in remembrance of Matiba. As they say, heroes don't die. Heroes should always be remembered and celebrated. As a country, we should always remember and celebrate Kenneth Nyindo Matiba. The opposition and the civil society has always celebrated Sabasaba Day, sometimes amidst tear gas. I think we should consider using that day, the Sabasaba Day, to remember Matiba, and maybe call it the Matiba Day. When I was Minister for Justice and Constitutional Affairs, we established a hero square in Langata, near Wilson Airport. But so far, there is nobody who is buried there, which means Kenyans do not consider themselves to have any heroes who can be buried in a hero square. Maybe time has come for us to rethink the purpose of that square, because I think that is where, in real terms, people like Kenneth Matiba, Jaramogi Oginga Odinga, and others should be resting. I know, reading social media, there have been a lot of commentary, some of which has been negative. Personally, I feel so painful to see some cynics who are not even there at that time trivialize the sacrifices that we made during the struggle for multi-party democracy in this country. As they say, when a giant dies, it's like an elephant. All manner of vultures and insects will climb on the dead elephant, try to dissect it, try to devour it, and others just to get visibility, you know, standing on the top of the corpse of the elephant. They want to be seen because they were invisible before. My plea is, please let us allow Matiba to rest in peace. His family has suffered a lot. His wife Wendy has suffered a lot. His children have suffered a lot. Let them rest in peace. I think I'm one of those who visited Matiba in 1992 when he was in hospital in London. And just before he died, I had occasion to visit him again at Karen Hospital in Nairobi a few days before his death. So let us not trivialize some of these things. As I said,